In this episode of FC Flashback, we are going to talk about Apoorva Raagangal, directed by K. Balachander. The film was released in 1975, so it's part of what I consider his greatest phase, which is roughly the period between Arangetram in 1973 and Sindhu Bhairavi, which was released in 1975. Why was this phase so great, or at least why do I consider this phase so great? Just listen to this line from the gorgeous M.S. Vishwanathan song that opens Apoorva Raagangal. This line loosely translates to how many questions exist in the chambers of the heart. It refers to relationships, and that is what a lot of this period of Balachander's films are about. Even Nagesh, who plays a secondary character in Apoorva Raagangal, has a complicated relationship background.
My wife, ஓடி போட்ட தெரியுமா? கல்யாணம் ஆகாம நீ தாயானே. கல்யாணம் ஆகியோ நான் பிரம்மச்சாரியனே வெளிய சொல்லிட்டேன்.
Now to the story. Srividya plays a classical musician who stumbles on Kamal Haasan, who is lying on the pavement bleeding. One day when she's returning home from a concert, she brings him home, she cares for him, and he gets better, and eventually he falls for her. In a parallel situation in Bangalore, Major Sundarrajan brings under his care a girl, a young girl played by Jayasudha, and gradually she falls for him. The twist is that the characters from both these storylines are already related to one another. As Jayasudha puts it,
ஒரு புதிர் சொல்றேன், அதுக்கு விடை கண்டுபிடிக்க முயற்சி பண்ணுங்க. என்னுடைய அப்பா யாருக்கு மாமனாரோ அவருடைய மருமகனுக்கு அப்பா என் மகனுக்கு மாமனார்.
Or as another character puts it,
விக்ரமாதித்யன் கதையில வர மாதிரி இருக்கு.
Or as Major Sundarrajan puts it,
your daughter is going to be your mother-in-law. And my son is going to be my father-in-law.
Or as the audience puts it. So yes, these contrivances are part and parcel of every Balachander film. And there are certain other things that some people don't care much for. Like the tendency of his characters to do these strange gestures. Like these dialogues that are sometimes provocative just for the heck of it.
Parala parala. Em whiskey neram 10 manikku da. Not now.
Na. உன்னே பண்ணிடுவேன் பயமா.
Sometimes, despite the fact that this director gave such meaty, big, heavy roles to most of his heroines, these women don't seem to have much agency of their own. See, for instance, what Srividya tells to the man who abandoned her when she was pregnant and has now returned after decades.
கையில மாலையோட வந்திருக்கீங்களா? அப்புறம் ஏன் தயங்குறீங்க? காலம் கடந்து போனாலும் என் கழுத்து இன்னும் காத்துக்கிட்டு தான் இருக்கு.
Of course, you know who this man is. He was introduced in this film. Then there are these things that came to be called the Balachander touch, which when seen today can seem somewhat overdone. Like when Kamal, who plays a firebrand communist, first sees a nude statue in Srividya's house, he covers it.
பணக்காரங்களோட ஆபாச ரசனைக்கு இது ஒரு எடுத்துக்காட்டு. இதுக்கு கூட வா துணி பஞ்சம். இனிமே இந்த அம்மாவுக்கு இதுதான் சாரி.
But when he falls in love with Srividya, he removes the cover. You know, it's symbolic and all that.
முனிவனுக்கே வந்த மயக்கம் முரட்டு உள்ளத்திற்கு வந்ததில் ஆச்சரியம் ஏதும் இல்லை.
But I love this filmmaker Watts and all because he kept trying out new things all the time. Some of them would work, some of them would not work. But in his peak period, his motto was, how can I make this scene more interesting? That sheer energy is fantastic and fascinating to see. I'm going to talk about some of these things. Because this film is about a classical music singer, Balachander divides his narrative into chapters whose titles are named after classical music terms. First chapter, for instance, is called Sarali Varisai, which are the beginner lessons that people learn in Carnatic music, and this is the beginning of the film. The very last frame of the film has the title Mangalam, which is the last part of the Carnatic Kacheri. And in between, the titles sometimes refer to ragas, like Jayasudha and Srividya, their characters are called Ranjini and Bhairavi. And when Kamal falls in love, the chapter is called Mohanam, which is also a ragam, and the meaning is enchantment or infatuation. The chapter for the Nagesh character is called Tukkada, which is a small, light, flavorful item played in a concert, and that perfectly suits the small and flavorful character. My favorite chapter title though is the one where Rajinikanth enters. To get a bit technical here, Shruti Bhedam is when the bass note of a ragam is changed and the ragam changes into another ragam. And to me, this suggests that the base of Srividya's life is being changed, because so far the partner we thought that she was going to be with is Kamal Haasan, and now it's Rajinikanth has entered the picture, so her life is going to go in a very different way. Two songs in this film are raga malikas, that is based on multiple ragas, and that goes with the multiplicity of these relationships. But I don't want to make this sound like a movie that you're going to enjoy only if you know Carnatic music. I love the writing in many scenes which have a beautiful open-ended quality. Like when Srividya brings Kamal home, you just wonder, why didn't she just take him to a hospital if she doesn't know him at all? And this question keeps coming up. This is wonderful writing. It reminds us of something that we are aware of, but it also reminds us of the fact that some things cannot or need not always be explained. Also, cinematically speaking, look at how many things Balachander does to keep things interesting. He cuts from one conversation to another mid-dialogue. In a song, he uses a series of jump cuts to highlight a character's alienation. He uses a voiceover on top of a freeze frame. And look at how he tells scenes visually. I'm talking about the scene where Kamal Haasan, in an early part of the film, he tries to leave Srividya's house. He is walking and his shadow is leading him, and she is on the terrace and her shadow falls right where his shadow is. It kind of looms over him, and he sees it, and then he kind of makes his decision not to go back again. That is, her influence is over him. No words, the scene is done. Another instance of shadows is with the Nagesh character. This time it suggests two personalities, as we are made to think that he has a kind of an evil twin. Or look at this great shot which happens after Srividya asks Kamal to stay at home and not hang out with his anarchist friends who are going to do something really bad. She ties a thread around his wrist and then ties the other end to the railing of a staircase. She returns home and the camera follows the thread as she walks with it. Kamal is playing the mridangam, and as we approach him, the vibrations in the thread become bigger and bigger. It's a beautiful way to show the strengthening of that bond, both musically and emotionally. And look at the last shot of the film, which beautifully frames him in a mirror and her in a keychain. They're just shadows of what once was. But above all, look at how Balachander changes the grammar of action filmmaking. You never look at K. Balachander and think of action scenes, right? But look what he does in the scene where Kamal is walking by and a car passes by and splashes water on him. He swears. This is probably the first time in Tamil cinema that we heard this particular swear word. Anyway, the men in the car hear it and they reverse the car and come back to Kamal, and they get out of the car and they ask him, okay, what did you say? And Kamal swears again. So we expect a fight, but what Balachander does is he pans his camera to each of the four men. That's it. We cut to the next scene when Srividya's car is coming back from the concert and she stumbles upon Kamal, who's lying battered and bleeding on the pavement. One look at Kamal is all we need to know what happened during the fight. We didn't actually have to see the fight. I love watching older films because they give you little glimpses of what came later and built on what these films were. Like the scene where Srividya sings swarams and Kamal plays the mridangam is the precursor of the Sipiya Rikada song sequences that came a few years later in Balachander's career, where Sridevi hums and Kamal replies with words. I love watching glimpses of Kamal becoming a great physical actor, like when he slams the door and it hurts his already injured wrist. I love how a small part of the Kamal character here is the archetype for future firebrands like Karthik's character in Maunaragam.
இது என் கொள்கை சம்பந்தப்பட்ட விஷயம்.
வன்முறையும் பலாத்காரமும் தான் உங்க கொள்கையா?
நான் வளர்த்த நம்பிக்கை லட்சியம். இதெல்லாம் உங்க விட்டு கொடுக்க முடியாது.
அடித்தடி ஜெயில் இதெல்லாம் தான் கொள்கைனா அது மாத்திக்கிறது தப்பு இல்ல.
I love watching Srividya who's brilliant here and due to the unfortunate life cycle of heroines would go on to play Rajinikanth's mother and mother-in-law in future films after playing his partner here. Old movies really take you on a journey. It's not just about that one movie, but about many movies that came before and memories that came after. The only thing about older films is that some aspects of their style may seem quaint today and some things may make us laugh a little, but when I laugh at least, I laugh with a lot of fondness and affection. I'll see you next week in the next episode of FC Flashback. Keep watching and do subscribe to Film Companion South.